Good morning, everybody, and welcome once again to Wacky Wednesday. Today, I've got something to show you. This is Prime 2009, and that's me as their cover girl. They had done an interview with me. Yes, I know what you're thinking. Dr. Priya, she doesn't look like you. I know, but that's not the point. The day this magazine was released, I got a complimentary copy. Copy in hand, I'd gone for a seminar. There, Betty Q, a dear friend of mine, introduced me to another friend. The lady looked at me and at the magazine and said, "Who are you?" I was amused. I said, "What do you mean?" She said, "Who are you?" I said, "I'm a human being." She said, "No, le, are you Malay? Are you Chinese? Are you an Indian? Or are you a mix? Or could it be that you are a Thai?" I smiled. I said, "Does it really matter?" She said, "Yala, I just want to know." I said, "No, I'm just a human being. Maybe I'm all of that and much more." "Yes," I said to her, "God is a great packaging agent. He packages us in different colors. Sometimes yellow, sometimes red, sometimes blue, sometimes black, sometimes white. And we, like silly toddlers, get enamored, get engrossed in the packaging and forget to check out the contents." Yes, dear friends, this point was beautifully elaborated, beautifully brought home by my daughter's first grade teacher in Eaton House, Mr. Blackburn, about 14 years ago. It was UN Day, United Nations Day. Each child had come dressed in their traditional outfit. My daughter too had gone to school wearing a beautiful ghagra choli, looking very beautiful. Mr. Blackburn, her teacher, made her stand beside him. He was from New Zealand. He looked at my daughter and said, "Srushti, where are you from?" My daughter said, "Mr. Blackburn, I am from India, but now I live in Singapore." He said, "I am from New Zealand, but now I live in Singapore." Then he looked at Srushti and said, "Srushti, I have one nose. How many noses do you have?" Srushti giggled and said, "Mr. Blackburn, even I have one nose." Then he looked at her and said, "I have two eyes. How many do you have?" The little child looked up and giggled and said, "Even I have two eyes." So on and so forth, he described the entire body. And then he said, "Srushti, when somebody says something bad or nasty to me, I feel very sad. I feel very bad. How do you feel?" Srushti said, "Yes, Mr. Blackburn, even I too feel very sad, very bad." Then he looked at her and said, "When somebody gives me a gift, I'm so happy. How are you, dear Srushti?" And Srushti said, "Yes, Mr. Blackburn, even I am happy." That day, in that moment, what this wonderful teacher had done is he had sowed the seeds of harmony, racial harmony, in each and every impressionable first standard kid. How these seeds were nurtured would determine how harmonious those children grew up to be and what a harmonious society they would create. Yes, children are simple. Children are pure. They take harmonious messages easily and grow up with them. But we adults, we are having solid rock minds. Our minds have all these separatist attitudes. So we need a slightly different handling. So dear children, if you're watching me now, it's time to go out and play. I need to talk to the adults. It's adult talk time. Yes, dear grown-up friends, come with me on a journey into the post-mortem world. It was my first post-mortem in a series of 20 every medical student has to do. Nothing had prepared me for this journey. When I entered, there was a stench of death, heavy in the air, heavy in the room. I was trying to put up a brave front, trying not to gag. Yes, all kinds of dead bodies were lying in different positions in that. On the dissection table were four bodies and an eager postmortem doctor waiting to teach 15 of us. 15 pairs of eyes and 15 brains ready to learn, peering on the table, trying to put up a very brave front. Yes, I will never forget those four people who were there on that table that day. One was a young Maharashtrian girl, a Brahmin at that, with long, beautiful hair, green bangles in her hand. She was 7 months pregnant and had committed suicide. I don't know why.
The second was a Catholic man. He was a police officer. He came from the south of India. He had fallen from a tall rise and died when on duty, leaving behind a wife and two kids. The third was a Muslim lady from the Middle East. She was at the airport when she had a massive heart attack. She was in an upmarket restaurant and was going to travel by business class. When he slit open her stomach, corn soup came out. For years after that, I couldn't even bear the sight of corn soup. So alive was it then. And the last was an unclaimed, malnourished body of I don't know whom. No class, no creed, no religion, no race. Probably a beggar on the street. I really don't know. But that day, in that moment, on that table, they were all one. Just dead bodies. Death had brought them on one leveling ground. The same knife was used for the dissection of each and everyone. We didn't use knives differently for different races, different class, different creed, or different caste. No, it was the same knife. Yes, we were trying to decipher death. Yes. On that day, I realized what they say in Christianity about Ash Wednesday, from Ash we came to Ash shall we return. Whether we are buried or whether we are burnt, in that moment, the ash of one man doesn't differ from another. The ground after the whole body has disintegrated, the mud doesn't differ. A beautiful poem by an Indian saint says, Mati kahe kumhar se, tu kya rondhe mohe, ek din aisa aega, main rondhungi tohe. The mud is talking to the pot and say, what are you mincing me? A day will come when I will mince you. Yes, like Mufasa says to Simba and Lion King, it is the circle of life. Let us not be proud. God is just a beautiful packaging agent. Let us learn to go beyond the packaging material to really who we are, because within ourselves we are all truly one, beyond the color of our skin, beyond our race, beyond our class, beyond our caste, and beyond our religion. We are truly one beautiful human race. So let's stop being homophobic. Let's instead be harmonious, happy humans here to take care of Mother Earth. On that point, thank you each and everyone, and wish you all a happy racial harmony.